I talked to you this morning about practicing, you know. Get this question all the time. First thing you got to do is, if you're practicing this, you can't be thinking at the same time about your pick, the strings, the guitar, you know. Your mind can't get into the minutiae of making music, okay? And you can't be thinking about, how am I going to use this? Don't think about that. Got to get this working, you know? The other thing kind of bugs me a little bit is a lot of people think that one tune is different than another tune. It isn't. So you have to know is that there's minor seven chords. They're usually two chords. Five chords, they're always five of something. And one chords. Okay? Then you get the minor. Minor seven flat five. Don't forget about playing a triad. Nothing wrong with a triad once in a while. Okay? When I was practicing coming up as a kid, I used to do this for hours. Inside the major scale is everything you need. You want Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, but So all you got to do is the major scale is like the game of Scrabble. You have seven notes, make a word, make a musical word, okay? Also, you have to take things in context. For example, I said earlier, minor sevens are usually two chords. Here's a case where it isn't. This is a two chord. One, six. Now, how hard is that to do in every key? It's not. One, six, two, five. You know, people are always practicing, you know, altered chords and all that. There's no need to do any of that. You know, when I play behind a soloist, I play three notes, two notes, D minor, G7. This way it gives the soloist time to play. I don't know how. I can't read the soloist's mind, what he's going to do, but I know that if I start going, you know, that's why reading out of the real book doesn't work. You don't know what the guy's going to play. You got to give him some space. You know, if I play this chord, G13 flat 9, and a lot of people think that, oh, that's a different scale. It's not. You got to make a melody. Now, if I play this, and here's what happens when you read out a real book. The real book says G13 flat 9, and everybody goes... Well, that's like writing on a white blackboard with white chalk. We're both playing the same thing. So it takes all the tension out of the soloist who's ever soloing. It takes all the tension out of his notes. You know, you're just wiping the guy out. If I play with a piano player, I'll comp D minor 7. Two notes, okay? Once in a while, maybe towards the end, if I know the piano player and I recognize that he likes to go. Then I may play that with him, but only at the end of the tune. But only if I know the pianist very well. Here's what a guitar player is supposed to do. If you have a piano player, stay out of his way. Now, if only any piano players out there, if they would do the same thing for a guitar player, stay out of the guy's way, you know, just because you got 10 fingers don't mean you have to have 10 notes in every chord you play. I hate that. I never play with piano players who have a tendency to do that, because they're limiting you in your soloing. You know, it's a drag. It's a real drag. So I don't play with guys like that. You know, a great example of staying out of each other's way is Jim Hall and Bill Evans. It's so beautiful how they both stay out of each other's way. Like, for example, they play, what's the tune? It's not Gone with the Wind. I can't think of it. Well, that's Gone with the Wind. Oh, I think they play I Got You Under My Skin. Same turnaround. Jim Hall goes. Real simple, okay? You don't want to lay on chords. You know, unless a ballad, maybe. See, the beautiful thing about music is there's no rules. Once you put rules to music, you're not making music anymore. You're playing rules. I mean, Mozart didn't have any rules. They made people analyzed music later and noticed what he did, commonly what he did. He made such great music, and so did Beethoven, with three or four chords. So it's just, when you practice, practice. When you play, play. It's different. They're 180 degrees apart. One's over here practicing, the other one's over here playing. Okay, they're not the same. It's not the same thing. So anyway, there I go with the word anyway. Also, maybe I should comb my hair, but I'm too lazy. I'm still in my robe. I've been in the robe for like 3 or 4 days. I'm thinking about maybe recording another solo guitar CD, but this time I'm going to do it for me, not for a record company and, you know, what they want me to play. Although, I never really had a problem with Concord Records people telling me what to play, but it's just nice to be able to figure out what I want to do and just do it, you know. I'm not going to do this one for monetary reasons. This one's going to be for me, and it's going to take a while. So don't be looking for it anytime soon. If I do it, I'll probably make it a download on my school, a free download for the students, and maybe a $5 download for people that aren't members of the school. But we'll see. Okay, thanks for your time.